Hello guys, welcome to Networkers Home. My name is Siddhanshu Kapoor. Today I am going to start the fourth lecture of Microsoft Azure Fundamental Series. The exam code of this series is AZ900. In this section, I am continuing Model 2 again. This is the part 3 of Model 2. In the previous lecture, we already learned about Azure Core Services, Azure Products and Pricing. Now in this lecture, we need to learn about how to subscribe in Azure and exploring Azure portal. So, as already we learn about Azure services, core services, Azure products and pricing. Okay. Now today we need to go for subscribe Azure. So let's start the lecture, guys. So in that I already opened azure.microsoft.com. Okay, you need to open this website. Okay, in this website, in the right of this site, we have option free account. So with the help of this free account, we can create a free account, or we can go for free subscription in Azure. So before we can go for free account, okay, you have at least one email ID. Either you can use Hotmail email ID, either you can use Outlook email ID, any email ID you can use in that case. Okay, so at least you have one email ID with you. Okay, so now after that, click on free account. Okay, now they ask you create your free account today. Okay, click on start free account. Okay, or buy now option is also there. If you want to buy the account, you can go for buy now option is also there. If you want to go for free account, so they gives you 30 days free trial account. Okay, so once I click on free account, they ask me what email ID you want to use, Hotmail, Outlook and all those stuffs. Okay, so if you have your email ID, if you can't use other account, you need to give your email ID, okay, and then password. Okay, so for me, I already subscribed with this. Okay, so if I need to go for subscription, okay, you need to first create one email ID. Okay, if you don't have any email ID, so right now I don't have any email ID, so we can go for create one. Over the option is there, create one. So click on create one over there. Okay, they create for you one email ID. Okay. So they ask me my name and all the things. Okay, so I go for they ask me to create this. Okay, so they ask me so I'll just go for get a new email address. Okay, so I first get an email ID. Okay, so over there I need to define my name, the user which I want to go for that. So I go for set.kapoor 87@outlook.com. Click on next. Yeah, it's available now. I need to give the password. Okay, so I give the password. Okay, now click on next. As you can see that create account. So they asked me to write this later. Letters. Like this, click on next. So they're showing you, they see automatically synchronize you on signup.azure.com. Okay, now try Azure for free. Now you can see that you need to about you. It's about you, your first name, last name, your email address, your phone number, and all those stuffs. After that, they're showing you identification verification by phone. They gives you one OTP. Okay, you need to define the OTP. After that, they ask you for card. Now, understand that if you subscribe in Azure, at least you have a credit card with you. It's not work on debit cards. Your Azure not works on debit card. You need a credit card for this to subscribe in Azure. If you don't have a credit card, you're not able to subscribe in Azure. Okay, so we need to give the information about credit cards. They deduct 2 rupees only, okay, in your credit card, and then after that agreement, click on accept the agreement, and then after that click on sign up. So they automatically create you the account. Understood? Okay, so this is the information you need to do. First you need to fill the about you page. In about you, you need to give the all information about you, and then verify by phone, then card information, your credit card information, and then go for agreement. Click on accept agreement and click on sign up. That's it. Okay, this is the way how you can sign up the sign up in Azure. Now after you sign up, you need to go to portal.azure.com, like this. This is the portal.azure.com. Okay, where you can open your Azure. So this is my Azure, you can say that. Okay, fine. So they open me, not this. I'm using, I need to sign out this. I use my previous account, which I already subscribed. Okay. So I have to log in with this account. This is my account. This is my account. I already subscribed with this account. Okay. sk@hotmail.com. So I need to use this account now. Need to find the password. Okay. And now this is the portal. You can see that. This is the Azure portal you have. Portal.azure. And this is the Azure portal you have. So this is the look of portal. Okay, so they're showing me the recent resources that what we can do recently. So about an hour ago, I can create load balancer, I can create test VM after two hours ago. Okay, they gives me 12,308 rupees. Okay, because I already using this account. That's why. If you subscribe a very fresh account, so they gives you 13,300 rupees. Okay, it means I already used that 1,000 rupees in that case. In this account. Okay, now you can see that free trial account is there, subscription is free trial. If I click on subscription, so they're showing me my subscription ID and everything is there. Okay, this is my free trial, so they gives me all the information about my subscription. You can see that. So if I want to cancel my subscription, I can cancel my subscription also. Okay, and they're showing me all the things. Okay, cost of my resources, whatever cost I am using right now. Okay, what are the resources I am using right now? These are the things they're showing me. Okay, fine, what is the usage of my cost and everything they're showing me. Okay, like this. So when I click on home, they're going me like this. So as you can see that I've seen all these services. So why are they showing me all these services? Because I already use these services. Like imagine, I'm going to create virtual machines in my Azure now. So I'm using virtual machine services. So once I use first time virtual machine services, I need to search over there. Okay, or I go for expand this one, this lines. And you have the options over there also. Okay, you can find over there virtual machines also. You can see that virtual machines are there also. If you want to create virtual machines, once you use the services, they're showing you over there also on the home portal. This is the home page, home portal. Over there, once you use any services, they're showing you over there also. Okay, fine. So now if you click on plus create a resource, but they're showing you all those things. What do you want? What resource you want to create? Okay, they gives you all the products are there. You want to go to compute, click on compute, whatever you want to use in compute. You want to create virtual machines, okay, you want to create database, you want to create network, okay, you want to create virtual networks, whatever you want to create. You want to go for storage, you want to create storage accounts, you can go for those things. Okay, you can use resource also, or you can go for this, click on this, and they're showing you all the stuff. Okay, once you click on all services, they're showing you all the services provided by Azure. Click on all, they give you all the services. In general, we have 15 services. In compute, we have 31 services. Okay, in networking, we have 29 services. You can see that 29 services over there. Okay, in storage, we have 15 resources we need to use. 15 services we can use. In storage, we can create 15 resources. Okay, in web, 14 resources we have. App services. Okay, we have 14 services, you can say that. In mobile, we have 3 services. In containers, we have 6 services. So we can see that in database, we have 19 services we can use. So many things are there we can use in Azure. Okay, so these are the all are the services provided by Azure. These are all services, you can say that. Okay, now you can see that we have home. So if I click on home, so I go for my home page. If I click again, I go for dashboard. So we have dashboards also. Like click on dashboards. Okay, so this is my dashboard. This is my default dashboard, you can see that. They're showing me all those stuffs, my recent resources which I'm using right now. Okay, and what resources you want to use. Okay, you want to customize this also. Like if you want to edit this dashboard, click on edit, and you want to add the resources also. Like if I don't want to use this, I delete this also. I don't want to use this. Okay, I don't want to use this also. And I don't want to use this. I want to make my dashboard again. Okay, so whatever sources you want. Okay, you want user activity summary. I want this user activity summary. Okay, I want users and groups over there. I can use this. Okay, whatever sources I need. I want virtual machines also. So I go for virtual. No, they're not showing me in the gallery. they're going me resource groups. I want resource groups as well. Okay, so whatever you want, okay, you can drag and drop the things and click on done. After once you done, you click on done customizing. Click on done customizing. This is your dashboard now. You can use the dashboard like this. Okay, now if you want to create multiple dashboards, you can create multiple dashboards as well. This is the by default dashboard. If you want to create another dashboard, click on plus, and this is the second dashboard. This is the word dashboard, or you can go for this is my dashboard 2. Okay, and you can create, I want this, I want clock options. Okay, okay, they ask me what clock you want to need, the zone time and the time format. I want 24/7 format, I want plus 30 zone. They go for that. Okay, I need this. You can say that I need marketplace, I need help and support over there. Okay, like this. So whatever you want, after you done the customizing, click on done customizing. This is my, so I have two dashboards now. This is my dashboard 1, the default dashboard, and I have dashboard 2. I can switch the dashboard as well. If you want to delete the dashboard, you can delete the dashboard as also. If you want to clone the dashboard, I want the same dashboard more, one more. Okay, so I go for clone the dashboard as well. This is the cloning of dashboards. Okay, done customizing. So I have three dashboards now. One is my by default dashboard. One is I will go to create my dashboard 2, and one is my clone dashboard, like this. If you want to delete the dashboard, so click on simple delete. Click on delete, click on OK. My dashboard is deleted. Now I want to delete this also. Click on delete, click on OK. Now I have only one dashboard, by default dashboard is there. Okay, fine. So this is what we have. If you want to share the dashboard, you can share the dashboard as well. You can go for full screen, you can go full screen as well. Okay, refresh the dashboard, you can refresh the dashboard as well, like this. Okay, fine. Now, this is the things you need to understand is, okay, these are the favorites. Favorite means if you want to add some services and favorites. So they're showing you over there, okay, on the left part. Okay, like I want that, okay, I'm using this services again and again, this service health. So I mark as a favorite. So you can see that. Once I mark as a favorite, I star it. I just go for that and just click on the star. It means it marked as a favorite now. Now I go for this and you can see that service health is there. They're showing me there in this area, in this favorite area. I don't want to search services again and again. Okay, if you want to search some services, I can search the services also over there. Like imagine I want to search some traffic managers, I go for traffic manager. It is a traffic manager I want to search. I want to search Azure Google Map account, I want to search. Okay, I want to search by subscription services, I go for subscriptions also. I click on that, they gives me the information about my subscription, my ID, free trial, whatever, they activate subscription right now. Okay, like this, we can go for that. Okay, fine. Now, we have up tools also, like we have settings also. Just click on settings, we have the portal settings, you want to set the themes. This is the default view, you want to change the portal, you want to change the portal, you want to change the themes as well. Okay, I want to change the contrast themes. Okay, if you don't want any notification, just disable notification over there. Okay, you need to change the language as well. If you want to change the language, we have so many languages are there, you can see that. Okay, so you can change the language as well. Okay, you can go for regional format, you can change the regional format language as well. Okay, so so many things are there. You can change your portal as well. If you want to modify your portal, you can modify the portal as well with the help of portal settings. Okay, they gives you over there, they gives you introduction, notifications. Okay, they're showing me that your free credit is expiring soon. It is for 8 days only, so 8 days left only, you can say that. Okay, in my portal, and I have 12,308 credit remaining are there. This amount is remaining till now. Okay, click here to upgrade to pay as you go subscription. So we can go for upgrade also. If you want to upgrade, you can click here and you need to upgrade the subscription also. Right now I'm working my free trial. If you want to upgrade the subscription, you can click here to upgrade the subscription also. Okay, if you want to sign out, you can sign out this over there. Click on that, click on sign out. This is the sign out option is there. Okay, this is the feedback option is there. If you want to give any feedback, okay, click on this. We have the feedback. You are satisfied with the Azure portal or not? You have any issues? Just submit the feedback. Okay, if you have any help, just click on this. They have a help option is also there. Click on help and support. Okay, so they automatically goes to this page, and over there you can send the request, which I already told you in the last lecture. Okay, so we can raise the request. We can see all my requests also. Okay, over there I can see the request, whether my requests are pending or not. Okay, I can see my services health also. Okay, services health means whatever services I am using right now. So services health is running or not right now. My all my services are properly running or not, they have any issues or not there. They're showing me the issues if I have any issues right there. Okay, so like this we can use these things. Okay, advisor, that gives you advisory also. Like if you have any issues, they give you, okay, you can do this thing, you can do this thing. That gives you advice also. Okay, if you have any issues, any common issues. Okay, they have some community also. Okay, we can add the join the communities also. Support plans. Okay, if you want to do any support plans, I already told you in the last lecture we have 4 support plans. You can use any support plans. Right now I'm not using any support plans. They're not showing me support plans right now. If I use those support plans, I can go for support plans also. Okay, they gives you the information about support plans right now. So right now I'm using the basic one. If I need to upgrade it, I am going to upgrade all these support plans also. Understood? Okay, so this is what we have. So this is the portal we have. Okay, fine. We have all those things. We need to understand this thing. So this is the portal. So with the help of this portal, we can manage our Azure services, Azure resources. Okay, so I hope you're able to understand how we can subscribe Azure. Okay, and how we can use the Azure portal. That's it for this session, guys. Thank you for watching.